morning, guys, and a warm welcome to Holland's Allotment. Hope everybody's staying safe, being practical, and keeping themselves out of harm's way. Today is the 5th of December. Wow, Christmas will soon be here before we know it, guys. 5th of December already. Right, okay, so not a lot happened through the week on the home front, other than how I've been working. Quite a productive week in my job. Managed to get quite a lot of calls cleared out, so yeah, I'm happy with that. Everything else just pretty normal on the home front at the moment, so no more taps to fit and things like that, which I'm sort of delighted about. Right, so we're a bit later getting to the allotment again today, guys, but it was still a productive morning. The reason for that was I was starting, my nose is running like a tap, it's freezing. The reason for that is because I realised I was starting to run out of the wood chips that I use for in the pigeon lofts under the floors, and there's still one or two lofts wanting cleaned out, but that's not going to happen this weekend. Or rather, if Tony keeps his promise, he's coming through tomorrow to do those for me while I get on with the garden area. So I needed to go and get a couple of bags of those. I had to wait until the shop opened. I was up about 7:30, but the shops don't open until 9 o'clock, so I had to wait until 9 o'clock to go and get these couple of bags of wood chips for the pigeon lofts, because on Sunday it doesn't open until 10 o'clock and I want to get started early tomorrow if we can, assuming Tony lands up on time. I've got the kettle on at the moment, you can probably hear it in the background. So we went and got those. We'd also run out of dog food, so I went and got two bags of dog food as well, the big bags of dry meal that we use. And sorry, just taking the gas can off there before it explodes. Tried to boil the kettle and it's that cold, I'm having to use the old gas on the top of the kettle syndrome. Right, so we got the two bags of wood chips, we got the two bags of dog food, and all this in the car as well, by the way, guys. Then we went on to the garden centre, because there isn't any of the superstores selling compost at this time of year. And I thought, you know what, if I'm going to do this garden right, if I'm going to do this garden this year, I want it done right. So we went to the garden centre, guys. Now, it is a little bit more expensive, but one, it gives trade to the small businesses that desperately need it in these times. And two, the quality of the compost is far superior to anything you get in the supermarket. And three, it gave me a little bit of discount because of the quantity. So we went down and we got 10 bags of 900 litres. So all just short of a ton of compost. It was a little bit expensive, but it should do it once, done. So we went and we got just short of a ton in the boot of the car there, and on the back seats and in the footwells. The poor car, it's been absolutely loaded up to the roof just about. Anyways, we've got it. So we got that brought up here, and then of course we went and fed and watered the pigeons and the chickens, as always, and a quick look over in the garden. So I'm really, really pleased with how things are going in the breeding section with the frill stencils. So last week I think I showed you the youngsters, I showed you me the ring in them on one of the videos, and then I showed you at the next stage where they were growing a bit and they were just starting to identify the colour. And I'm pleased to say one of them is an Andalusian toy stencil. It's got the white ribbon tail as well, so, and it's going to be beautiful, it really is. And they're almost ready for coming off the nests. I may take them off the nests tomorrow. I'm leaving them on for today because it's really, really been bitterly cold these last couple of nights, and we've had some hard frosts. Thankfully, they got to the size they have, and they've feathered up nicely. And as I say, they're all the two on the top almost are ready for coming off anyway. I might have to pop up midweek to take the other two off because they were 4 or 5 days behind the other ones at hatching. But they're coming along nicely as well. And what I did spot was what I thought was two blacks. One of them is a toy stencil as well. Frill stencil anyways. Toy stroke frill stencil. It's a very complex gene, is the toy and frill stencil. And birds can carry both, hidden, and display one or the other or both. But they can be carrying. So a toy and frill stencil are much of a similarity. But it's the frill stencil that produces the white markings and the toy stencil produces bronzes, which can develop into whites, depending on the pattern of the bird and the colours you're using. So one of the blacks is developing brown bars, or a brown check, but it's certainly got some brown bronzing in the bird. So it's an F2 black, but it's carrying, in fact, it probably will molt out to be a toy or frill stencil, in all probability. The other one was sitting behind it, and I didn't pick it up and spend a lot of time examining the birds, but we will give you a look at those later on, guys. So the main thing I want to do today is have this cup of coffee. It's now 11:30, and thankfully it's a bright sunny day, but it's bitterly cold. So we might get that extra hour's daylight that I've lost this morning, because I'm only getting approximately 3 hours, guys, in daylight before it's cold, too cold or miserable to do anything, or starting to darken in by the time I put the tools away and all the rest of it. So I've got very limited time. But what I do hope to do is go over in, straight over there, as promised, after this cup of coffee, and make a start weeding those beds. Unlike the last bed that I showed you on the video, where I decided to bring some of the soil down below up and mix it in with last year's pretty poor compost, I ordered Charles Dowden's 2021 calendar. It was a little bit on the expensive side for what it is, to be honest with you. However, you're paying for his knowledge as well, guys. And it breaks it down, when's the best time to plant X, when's the best time to plant X, beetroots, cabbage, radish, all the rest of it, when to sow undercover, when to plant out. And to be honest, I'm a novice, so I don't really have a massive amount of experience. And as you know, last year was my first year trying the no-dig system. And I have to say, considering we got and it went through an entire growing season, even looking at those beds, there's not a lot of weeds in there, guys. And it has been minimal effort. But more importantly, I didn't dig anything last year, so that was a massive saving in effort as well. And this year, so what I've decided, it does say that in winter when you're preparing your beds, I know he's far more advanced than I am, and I'm still in the early stages of the no-dig. But what I've decided to do is I'm not going to disturb the soil underneath and mix it in. So we've done it with one bed, and we'll see the difference as the year progresses, whether we get more weeds in that bed as a result of doing that. So what I've decided I'm going to do is I'm just going to use a little hand fork or trowel, and I'm going to just prise out the biggest weeds. That's all I'm going to do, take out the biggest ones. Any small ones, they'll be covered over with cardboard. Then the cow manure will go on top, and then we'll dress it off with the compost, guys. And that will, basically, we're going to start building the structure in the beds now. And we should see a big difference. And also, because we put another layer of cardboard on, we shouldn't see any weeds. Or very, very minimum amount of weeds. And secondly, it'll be easier. So I want to take out the big perennials, like the deep-rooted dandelion and docking leaves. There isn't a lot, so it shouldn't take too long. And then I can get cracking and hopefully get on with those beds. I don't know how many I'll get done today and how long the light will last out. However, that's my intention, guys. If you're new to my channel, please do think about hitting the subscribe button. Then hit the little bell icon on the right, and that'll alert you every time I put up a new video. Thanks for bearing with me, guys. I'll try and give you some better content today. Stay with me, and we'll see you later. I'm going to try and give you some footage from the tripod camera today. I tried the wireless microphone, and that just did not work at all. Even with brand new batteries, resetting the frequencies, I think the actual connector on the microphone socket, where it's got an adapter for the camera, is a bit weak and it's not making a correct connection. I think that's all it is. We might just need another little fly lead. Hopefully you can hear this audio okay. So what we've done here now,
like I said, we haven't dug the bed. I've simply put the fork in, eased it, and I've only taken out the nettles and dock leaves, like dandelion leaves, dandelion root, because it was down pretty deep, even this late in the year, and there was only five or six, and then there was a couple of old Brussels sprout stalks in there, and a couple of cabbage ones, and we've just literally eased it, pulled them out, and walked back on this bed. As you can see, I'm just walking all back over it again, and pat it back down, and firm it down. And then what we're going to do, actually I've just spotted another nettle there, so we'll get that out of the road as well. And then what we're going to do is just put cardboard on here, down with the manure, and then we're going to get the compost in there. So I hope this audio is coming out all right, guys. We'll just see how it goes. If not, then we'll have to exclude it, and we'll give you a look around when we're finished. See you shortly. Right, guys, as you can see, we've now got that bed weeded, dressed, and covered in cardboard. You see there's some little tiny bits in the bed as well, and the reason for that is you've got to cover every single piece in the bed. So if you, where you have a join in the cardboard, if there's a little thin gap, a weed will come through that. So you want to overlay it and cover absolutely every single gap. Then the manure will go on top of there. I'm just going to crack on with this other bed over here now, guys, and get the cardboard in this one. We're ready to start putting the manure in and the compost on top of these. Right, guys, I've decided to do something different again from what I said I was going to do. So I'm going to do an experiment as usual. And you can see we've got this cardboarded out here now. And that's ready. And we're going to leave that like that. Purely and simply because there was a couple of weeds in there. We've took out the worst, two or three tiny ones, cardboard on. Then we'll get the manure. And then we'll get the compost on the top as a final dressing. And I'm going to leave the beds exposed to the weather for the time being, because I want plenty of rain on there to start breaking that cardboard down. Otherwise the potatoes won't, well, they may not be able to push through the way I want them to do next year. Conversely, with this bed here, I've now decided, instead of putting the cardboard in, this is the bed that we very gently turned the underneath soil, that was the existing soil, we very gently forked that in to the old compost from last year that was very poor. So what I'm going to do with this one, with this bed here, we're just going to not cardboard it, and I'm going to put straight on with the cow manure, then the compost, and leave that one the same. And it's just the one bed, so that if this doesn't work, I'll only have the one bed to struggle with. And next year we'll have learned from that lesson, and we'll cardboard it the following year. But I just want to see what sort of a difference we get between that bed and this one. Right, guys, so what we've done now is we've got the cow manure on top of this bed here, on top of the cardboard. And with this one here, we didn't put any cardboard on. We done what we said. We went straight on top of the already gently mixed undersoil with last year's soil and the wood chips in that we put on from last year when we grown potatoes in these two beds. Now, you remember last year I only grew potatoes in this bed and that bed and the one behind me, and we got a fantastic crop out of these, just these two beds alone. And like I said, I'm going to fill every single bed this year with early potatoes, and then we'll plant something else after that. We'll decide what. Another point I want to make, you can see the levels on the bed now are almost up to the top. We've left just enough room to get a bag of compost on there. Conversely, if you look at these beds here, you'll see they've sunk quite a bit. They're almost half the board down now. They've dropped almost half a board, and in some areas a little bit deeper. Another point I want to make, although it may look bad on camera, is this is all the weeds we got in one year. I didn't do any weeding of these beds last year at all. We just went down with the cardboard, as you know, guys, straight on barren soil, cardboard, and then we put the compost in there, guys. This one here is probably about the worst bed. And again, for a whole year and not being weeded, that's not bad. So I just wanted to highlight that as well, guys. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get these bags of compost dressed onto the beds. And at least that's two beds ready, guys. See you soon. Guys, so as I'm going along, I keep chopping and changing my mind. So what I've done now is, we've got this bed here, as you can see. We've got the cardboard, we got it weeded, a couple of perennial weeds, got those out, cardboard down, cow manure on top, all broke down with the fork to loosen it up, get it aerated, and let the worms finish the job on it. We're also going to leave it open to the elements so that when we get some rain, that will all add and help to break down the cardboard below. Then we will top it off and cover it with either cardboard or plastic to stop us losing any nutrients out of there, guys. But we'll go back to our experimental bed now. Excuse me. And as you can see, we're up level with the top of the board now. Now, we weren't even that level last year. We didn't have it that high. I think there was only enough compost to fill these beds for the first time round, just slightly more than the half level that they are already. But with this bed now, we've got a... So we've got... we've done the lightly digging on this one with the last year's compost and everything, and brought some of the new soil up from underneath. This is our experimental bed. And we broke all that down and we weeded it. We didn't put cardboard on, then we went straight on top with a layer of manure to feed the bed. And now we've just put one 900 litre bag, took a full 900 litre bag to finish this off and flush it with the top. And you can see I've firmed it down as well, guys. You can't compress compost. But I haven't walked up and down it. I literally used my hand to just firm it down. And that's so that it doesn't actually, if you get heavy rains, it doesn't spill over the sides more than anything. So we just simply firmed that down now. And we're going to leave that uncovered for a week or so. Again, let the elements get in there, start to let it sink naturally, and then we'll cover it over. Now, it's already 2 p.m, believe it or not. By the time I found the camera, found the memory card, found the battery, got the microphone set up, I tried the wireless microphones, which I couldn't get to function at all, even with new batteries, guys. So, and thankfully the charge appears to be holding out in the little boom mic on this camera. This really is a good piece of kit. I should use it more often. So what I'm going to do now, guys, probably today, again, because we're fast running out of time by the time we got everything done. So what I'm aiming for today, I want to try and get this weeded with all the worst of the weeds. And this bed here as well, guys. So yeah, we underestimate the work that it takes, but yeah, it's got to be done. So we didn't get as much done as we thought we were going to, but we'll crack on and I'll catch you later, guys, and give you a look around when I'm finished. Right, guys. So we've got this bed here weeded now, and that took approximately 10 minutes. And I just want you to see that there is a full year's weeding, guys. It's about a forkful, to put it in perspective. I know it looks like a great mountain. I'm zooming in for a reason. If you look at these weeds here, you'll see the roots on these. They're relatively long, but not that bad. More importantly, these weeds came out exceptionally easy. I didn't have to dig. All I needed to do was to actually put the fork in like that, prise back just a touch, and they literally just picked out and came out with the root and everything. And what's important and interesting here, guys, is we put cardboard down under here last year, and not one of those weeds had came up through the cardboard. In fact, I actually went a little bit deep with some grass. There was a tuft of grass, and I thought that's going to be down well, but it actually wasn't. And I went a little bit deep, and what's more important is the old cardboard from last year is still there. It is breaking down, but it's still holding those weeds back. And every one of these weeds are top rooted, meaning that it's weed seeds that's blew in and settled on the compost and took root, rather than came up through the bottom, guys. So I'm not even going to cardboard these. I'm going to go straight on with the manure. I'm going to firm it all back down when I'm finished. I'm going to go straight on with the manure, and then we're just going to leave that for the elements to break, finish breaking it down a little bit before we actually dress these beds off and then put them to bed completely for winter. And that there is an entire year's weed in there, guys. So I could probably take the garden fork, put it underneath, and there's probably a garden fork full. But more importantly, by putting the garden fork in and just pressing back just a tiny touch, because I wanted to make sure I got the roots, they just picked out like that, guys. Simplicity itself. Definitely worth going down the no-dig route, guys, if you don't already. And again, likewise here, I'm going to say that every one of these, what there is, which is even less in this bed than the other one, is it's going to be all top-rooted, and it's wheat seed that's blew in during the summer months. See you later, guys. The light is fast fading on me now. It's 3:05. We've managed to get a bit longer today than we did last weekend. My battery is also about to die in the camera. So I'll give you a quick look around now, guys. We've got a little bit more done than I expected in the end. So we've got this bed done, which you watched me doing earlier in the video. That one with no cardboard. We've got these two beds weeded. This one here. And this one here as well, guys. And we've got the cow manure on. Now you can see from there it's still a bit lumpy on these beds. And I've cleared, that compost hasn't gone as far as I thought it was going to. However, it is going to finish the job. And it's been a massive blessing in saving and cost on the compost this year. Because it's rather expensive. But we'll get it done this year, guys, and then it's right. So we've got that done. We've still got this bed here to do. I'm just going to leave the bags of compost out, guys. It'll take no harm. And we've still got this bed here to do. And as you can see, there's a couple of what looks really bad weed-wise. But to be perfectly honest, they'll be out in a couple of minutes. I also found an even easier way of doing this. You know the weeds I was telling you about? They were just surface weeds. I got the little three-pronged fork. I have a miniature one as well as the big one that I use for breaking up this. And all I've done was I just literally scratched the surface like that, and the weeds just popped out, roots and all, guys. Really, really easy it was. So it was even easier doing that bed there. And, yeah. Right, guys. The battery is about to die. We'll try again. This is a final roundup out here, guys, purely and simply because if I take you over into the shed for to finish off on the roundup, you won't be able to see a thing. Hopefully the audio is coming out on this okay. So quite a productive day again, as you can see. We got quite a lot of done this morning before we even arrived here. You're not going to get a look at the pigeons, the young pigeons today, but we will tomorrow. I really need a cup of coffee because I've never stopped since I came over here, guys. And as I say, it's 3:10 in the afternoon now. So I'm going to wrap it up here, right now, today. I'd just like to thank you all again for following me along on my channel. I really do appreciate it. Another one or two subscribers since last week. Thank you very much for your subscription, guys. It's much appreciated. Please do follow me along, and if you aren't already subscribed and you're watching this for the first time, guys, think about hitting the subscribe button, please, and then the little bell icon on the right. It doesn't cost anything to subscribe to my channel, and hopefully it'll entertain you. For now, guys, stay safe, be practical, keep yourselves out of harm's way, and we'll see you again tomorrow, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.